today is the dominant consumer electronics company in the world. It is the result of the vision of one man. Now, I want to be careful to not to suggest that all the successes of Apple are attributable to Steve Jobs, because they aren't. But the strategy and the culture of Apple truly are attributable to Steve Jobs, and Steve Jobs alone up to this point. And so keep it hidden as if you were the owner of Apple. And the irony there is that when he left the company in 1986, he sold all of his shares except for one share, so he had 10 shareholder meetings in a huff because he was angry. And so he was not a big shareholder. Even at his death, he owned far more of Disney because of his Pixar stake than he did of Apple. But he behaved as if he controlled the company. He ran as a long-term company. And a long-term investment. So even in the recession of 2001, Apple was investing heavily in its products, in the iPod, and in advertising the Apple brand. This is one of the reasons why Apple has been able to have outside success, because it invested for the long term. Now, the other thing that Apple did famously under Jobs was to focus on what it wanted to do and to make products that he and his executives wanted to use. So they understood the product and they understood their customer extremely well, because in their opinion, they were the customer. And Jobs would say, we hated our smartphones. We knew we wanted to build the iPhone. We hated using PCs. We knew what changes we wanted to make to the Mac, and so on. We loved using music. We loved listening to music, and so we knew what we wanted in a music player and in a jukebox software. And so, by answering to themselves in terms of product features, they were able to build truly breakthrough products that their customers would also